I'm back at Knockan Hill Park to finish off this painting of the camas and the oaks. It's a very lovely hot evening, and I don't know if you could hear, but the birds are just going crazy, so it's perfect music to listen to while I paint in the park. So I'm just oiling in with some linseed oil mixed with Damar varnish. And this is just going to re-wet the canvas and make it easier for me to paint back into it. On my palette, I have titanium white, Naples yellow, cadmium lemon, medium cadmium orange, light cadmium red, quinacridone violet, alizarin crimson, burnt sienna, iron violet, ultramarine blue, Prussian blue, permanent green, viridian, ivory black, and azo green, yellow ochre, Portland gray, and a white-blue mixture that I make myself. This white-blue mixture that I make depends on the atmospheric conditions. For a cooler color, I use ultramarine blue mixed with white. If I'm going for like a summer sky, I like to mix titanium white with a bit of Prussian blue, and it just gives a slightly more green cast to the blue. So as I'm doing these, I'm never really sure where they're gonna go, especially when I'm working back into something. I'm trying not to completely cover up my previous work. Otherwise, I find the surface feels a bit suffocated and heavy, so I want to keep it brushy and loose and my strokes fairly light. I just had to change the camera angle. The sun was shining in the lens. I'm working in my foreground and I trying to create like a anchor for everything that's going on top. Mostly I've been using this fan brush, and I find it's been helping me stay loose. I think I've got to come in with these long flaps to really cut in some of these rock shapes.
Now, Knockan Hill Park is a Garry Oak Reserve, so it was used by the Native Americans, and it was a food source at various times of the year. This particular glade that I'm in, this spot, there's not very many people here, ever. I don't think I've ever seen another person here, but the rocks are kind of broken and piled with these oaks growing between them and on top of them, and then there's open flat areas that grow beautiful scented flowers, and there's something very sacred about this place. It feels sacred, and I don't know if that's just my imagination, but I often find that I whisper when I'm in this spot without realizing it.
I've been having a lot of fun with this fan brush. I always kind of avoided it, but I'm really liking it. I'm really embracing its spontaneity. It's really good for a painter like me, who I always have the desire to paint looser, but I just sort of end up going more detailed. This sort of forces you to not do that, because you really can't do much detail. It just lays down paint wherever it likes. gotten quite a bit darker. It's still really beautiful. There's a lot more atmosphere happening right now in the background than before. The sky has taken on a bit of a orangish peach color down lower. I might include that. I'm gonna cut back these sharp edges. You don't want too many of those. This is leading away from your main scene. So I'm gonna cut that back a little bit. There we go. All right, time to pack it up.